reality is there's a lot of material out there on various soft skills, oral communication, written communication, problem solving, and so forth. But all too often, the material I was finding was a great big book. So if I'm teaching computer programming or database design or networking, I don't want to bring another great big book for the students to have to read. Rather, I was looking for simple material that I could add in the middle of the class that I was teaching to enrich and enliven it. And so I started developing my own material, and that was really the genesis of these soft skill study guides. One of the key design goals of this particular series was to make it as self-teaching as possible. The professor or the teacher can be involved as little or as much as they feel comfortable with. A lot of the material teaches itself, a lot of the assessment grades itself, and the students really can work through this material independently and still learn a lot from it. But what we do with this particular series is try to, as often as possible, put the student in a particular context or scenario where they see why this is important, how it's used, and as much as possible have the student make decisions based on these scenarios. And what we find is then when they get out beyond the classroom into the real world, they're better able to remember and apply those skills they've learned.